boldness, and minister your justice with compassion for the sake of our Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Story of our ancestors in faith, as told to us in the book of Exodus. When the people of Israel had journeyed from Rephidim, entered the wilderness of Sinai, and camped in the wilderness, Israel camped there in front of the mountain. Then Moses went up to God. The Lord called to him from the mountain, saying, "Thus you shall say to the house of Jacob, and tell the Israelites, you have seen what I did to the Egyptians, and how I bore you on eagle's wings, and brought you to myself. Now therefore, if you obey my voice and keep my covenant, you shall be my treasured possession out of all the people. Indeed, the whole earth is mine, but you shall be for me a priestly kingdom and a holy nation. These are the words that you shall speak to the Israelites." So Moses came, summoned the elders of the people, and said before them all these words that the Lord had commanded him. The people all answered as one, "Everything that the Lord has spoken, we will do." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm this morning is Psalm 100, found in your bulletin. Let us say in unison, "Be joyful in the Lord, all you ends.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
which means one who is sent on a mission. Jesus transfers his ministry to the 12, but more than that, he entrusts his ministry to them. With just their own observations of Jesus as somewhat of a foundation, the apostles are now sent to do exactly the same work as Jesus, which is to proclaim the good news of God's kingdom, to cure the sick, to raise the dead, to cleanse lepers, cast off demons. And maybe the most important words are, you received without payment, give without payment. Another translation makes this statement clearer. The message of the good news of Jesus was free when you got it. Make sure it's free when you give it. Doing good work without proclaiming good news, that's just work. Which is not what Jesus is sending the 12 to do. Jesus tells them to take nothing with them, absolutely nothing. We would never do that. That is just so stupid. It's just dumb. So what is he thinking? Maybe it's so the apostles will understand that the only thing they have to offer anyone else, the only thing, is what they themselves have been given. Whatever they give comes from what has been given to them. At Good Shepherd, all of us are disciples. We're learners. We're followers of Jesus. But did you know that all of us are also called to be apostles? To use those spiritual gifts we've learned about in our session with Word and Doctrine out in our community. We are charged and encouraged to go every Sunday at the end of the service. We hear, let us go forth in the name of Christ, or go in peace to love and serve the Lord, or let us go forth rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Yes, in these words, we are called to be apostles for Jesus Christ. Unless we think, oh no, Fergie, I've got to have everything together before I do that. Remember the lesson of the 12. Because the one who sends us out with nothing at all sends us out with everything we need. With healing. With forgiveness. Restoration and resurrection. Those are what we have to share with the world. And frankly, they're the only things the world really needs. Like the apostles, Jesus sends us out with nothing at all, and yet sends us out incredibly with everything we need. And all God's people say, Amen. Please stand.
together in your love and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. We remember those on our parish prayer list: Jody, Elizabeth, Jim, Patty, Mish, Pat, Ann, Jerry, Juby, Bill, Mike, Jim, Paula, Lewis, and Judy.
For Jim, Faith.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom.
For Bill.
Carrick. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Almighty and eternal God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people and strengthen us to do your will through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your
celebrated today in thanksgiving for all fathers. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give you thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. For you are the source of light and life. You made us in your image and called us to new life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses.
blessing